back to MG Midget, the birth of a race car, capturing my journey from car restoration to the 2022 MG Car Club Speed Series. In this episode, we're going to have a look at the pedal box. So before we even start on the pedal box itself, first thing to do has been to reinstall the accelerator pedal cable. So what we've done here is I fortunately already had one nut up here, one welded in nut on the bulkhead that was kept, so I was able to use that as a datum, fitted the bar back in place, and I had to drill a hole through our new metalwork here to fit the second bolt in. So I've reattached the accelerator cable that just simply comes through the bulkhead and clips into the accelerator arm, and next thing I'm going to have to do is refit the accelerator pedal, which is going to mean drilling some holes in the floor. So what I'm doing here is just dry fitting the pedal and checking that on full stroke I can get the full pedal movement, and then positioning the base along the floor where I want it, so that then when I release it comes to not quite but kind of virtually near vertical, and then when I push down I can still get the full throttle. So I've done that now. So what I'm going to do is mark the floor with a sharp rod through the drill hole, and now I'm ready to drill the hole in the floor. Do this using a 6.5mm drill. Ready to dry fit. Pedal. So once you get the pedal box off, it's actually quite easy to work on. You've got your clutch pedal and your brake pedal held in underneath this bracket that fits in the engine bay by this screw that grows across here. I've already done a bit of work on this. I've taken the screw out, cleaned and painted up the pedals, and then reassembled the pedals here. When I took it apart, I found that this was stiff and tight, so that's not good for pedal action. So it involved quite a bit of degreasing of this shaft and cleaning it out in order to get that to move nice and smoothly. But that's now reassembled and ready to go back in. On the other side of the pedal box, you've got the two cylinders, the two master cylinders. They're mounted up to the bracket on the front. You've got your reservoir here, and then you've got the pin coming through, held together with a clevis pin and a split pin here. So this is the brake master cylinder. So I've decided to replace both master cylinders with new ones. Certainly my experience with hydraulics, particularly with brakes and clutches, is that it just isn't worth trying to repair these things. For the cost of new parts, it's easier just to fit new parts, knowing that you've got good hydraulic seals, and that will certainly pay dividends when it comes to bleeding the brakes and bleeding the clutch. Underneath here on the pedal box, we've got this small hole here, and that is where the return spring connects to the underbody of the car under here. So we've got two new return springs to go on there as well. The old ones were fairly well rusted and not something I can trust anymore, so we're going to be fitting new return springs as well. So last thing to do on this particular assembly then is to get the clutch master cylinder into place, get the clevis pin through, and then it'll be ready to fit back up to the car. So with the cover on and the new seal, foam gasket underneath, we're all ready to fit it to the car. Pedal box then all in situ, and what I'm going to do now is just fit this little adapter to the top of the clutch cylinder. This is one of the causes of a whole world of pain when bleeding the clutch. So we'll come back to that in a later video when we bleed the clutch, but make sure you've got a nice new copper washer on that, and then that can just screw in finger tight at the moment. And then last part of this is we need to connect up the two copper pipes, one for the clutch down to the bracket there, and the second one over to the four-way split on the brakes. So I'm going to make those up now. So they're connected to the pedal box. First of all, we've got the brake pipe routed along the bottom of the footwell to the four-way connector, and then up from where the slave cylinder flexi pipe is going to be mounted, we come up to the top of the front of the footwell, across, up the left hand side of the pedal box, then we've bent back on ourselves to go into the clutch master cylinder. And indeed it's this kind of vertically kind of pointing upwards piece here, together with this union here, which is what causes so much grief and pain when bleeding the clutch, as that's where a lot of the air gets trapped. But when we bleed the clutch, we'll show you how to deal with that. Now the pedal box is in, it's a nice easy job just to fit the two pedal springs, just to give them a nice good return. Last part of the pedal box then is to fit up two nice new rubbers for the clutch and the brake, and that gives our control centre its final touches. So, it's on to the next job.